Hello everyone. In this video, I am going to show you all how to make two very easy educational toys and what is the activity that you can do from it. So the first educational toy that I have made at home is this. This basically is a box. Okay, so I have painted a neutral color in the box first. So I've taken white as a background. I've painted it using poster paint. On that, what I've done is I've made some holes like that using this scissor. So you make sure you at least have a hole where you can put your finger in. You know, it doesn't necessarily, at least your little finger should be able to pass through it. So I made different holes on this. Some on the side, some here, some this, some here also. If you want, you can make it 360 all around. You can make hole. I have chosen to make it in the front and on the side. After I have made the hole, I have made holes. I have painted the holes with different colors. So here I have used four basic colors: the red, blue, yellow, and green. And I made sure the blues, the same color holes are slightly separate or slightly have some distance. So this is your box ready. On this box, you will need some pipe cleaners like this. You can buy it from the market easily. And you can ask the children to put it. For example, I'll put one in yellow here and one in yellow here. So matching blue one, I can put this and I can put here. I can even put blue here. So this is the toy. Most of the children, when I present it in the class or in the school, sorry, the toy is kept like this. I actually don't have green round. This is fluorescent that I'm using for the time being. So I keep it like this. The reason so is when a child sees a toy like this, it gets very inquisitive. They like to explore what is this thing, which is quite uncommon, and what is this, you know, colors that's coming out from it. So the children come first, they try to see why this is happening. And then they start fidgeting around the toy and start exploring how it works, first and foremost. Again, I like to stress that this is for a toddler group and play group. Now, toddler group children will not know colors, may have not learned colors by then, or the naming of the colors. So they can start just by learning how to put this pipe cleaners inside the hole. So this is their fine motor skill. It is very easy for an adult to do this, but for a toddler, 1 year old, 1.5 year old kid, it takes concentration and focus and a lot of coordination, hand and eye coordination especially, for them to able to do this simple activity. So initially they will put in different holes. Once they start getting exposed to colors, and when I start saying, look, this is blue, you should put it in blue, look, this, what is the color, this is blue, or even before I mention blue, if I say this and this is same, look at it. So we can introduce the kids to using this. This will be for toddlers, their early color understanding. So before you even name it, this your, what you say, preparedness for that. For children who are around 2 year old, 2.5 year old, my playgroup kids once, this can be a reinforcement activity after introducing colors. So say for the playgroup kids, I've already introduced, or even for my nursery kids, I've introduced this four basic colors: red, yellow, blue, and green. Then I'll ask my students, can you please do this exercise correctly? Can you play with this? So this is a toy which creates, it's a very simple toy, very easy to make at home, and something which creates a lot of curiosity, inquisitiveness in the child's mind, and they love to explore this simple toy. Easy toy, very good in reinforcing colors, what they have learned through a game or with this toy, or it, even for toddlers, for preparing for them to understand, visually understanding colors even before naming it. So when I tell a toddler, this is blue, this is blue, so this blue should go here, that itself, when a toddler is able to do that, it shows that a child is able to visually match this too, right? So these are some of the very easy toys. Also, another very good part about this toy is it's actually very engaging for children of that age. They love to keep on playing with it for quite some time. And in toddlers and playgroup kids, you will see it takes them quite some time to actually understand it. So it is kind of challenging for them at their developmental stage. So this toy is something that they can engage for a long period of time. So this is the first toy. Another toy I have is, in this toy I have used, you can see, this is a OLED carton that I have used. You can even use the only one which is here, or even the longer one, a bigger one, depending on what is available at your house. I have painted some colors here. Here again, I have painted the basic colors. I have done red, yellow, green, blue, pink, orange. You can choose the color. Generally, for when you are introducing colors to children, for a toddler or a playgroup age, we will be using the basic colors. As we move ahead, the secondary colors will be added. So I have this, I painted this and kept it. That's about it. And then I have kept some pom-poms of the same color. Now I'll ask the student, can you sort the colors? So your activity is put the yellow in the yellow, orange here. What color is this? Green. So this goes here. Where this is red. Red goes where? The red. Pink. Letter. Color pink goes here. So this is how you can introduce. So once you've shown or demonstrated to the kid how this activity is done, they can do it on their own. Again, this is a good reinforcement game for the children. And say this can be also used for another reinforcement, counting. So counting, when we teach counting or we teach numbers at the LKG or at the nursery stage, is generally we like to teach along with a value. When it's a numerical representation, as in like number one is written like this, right? Or two. And then the value of it. For example, one. How many red ball are there? One. This is two. Three, four, five, six, seven. So we are helping them practice counting and understanding the value of numbers. Similarly, they can do for different colors, like one yellow, two yellow, three yellow, four yellow, five yellow, six yellow, and so on. So what are we doing? We are making them reinforce colors, as at the same time we are helping them start counting. So both this can become a little bit more challenging for nursery and for nursery kids if you add more colors. Here both the toys I have made keeping in mind the toddler and playgroup students. So if you are making this, I can probably use a bigger one, okay, with little bit more complexity, where they have to go through. For example, if this green has to pass through here and come out, right? So the hole goes, you have two holes from both sides where it can pass through, right? Like that. And you can also add more colors. colors which will introduce later, the secondary colors or different more colors that you want. Similarly here, if I have more number of colors, rather than having 6 colors, if I have 12 or 20 colors, and if I have more number of pom-pom, this can actually help you in counting till 10, till 15, till 20, as you please. So these are the 2 very simple educational toys which you can make at home and which will engage the kids. Thank you very much for listening.